All right, guys, welcome back. We're right where you left off in Hogwarts Legacy. It already seems to be a great game from the prologue. If you did not watch that episode, I highly recommend. The prologue was surprisingly fantastic. It was more than I expected from this game's prologue. I thought it was going to be a very simple prologue and have a just a very simple intro, just so that it could throw you into Hogwarts. But no, I was completely wrong. It was so much more and better than I expected. So there's apples everywhere you can eat. We got some students here. The Hufflepuff common room. Shit, this like, oh. Sorry. Yeah, it looks really good. So this is the fast travel system, the flame. What is it called? Flume powder? Something like that. I don't remember. I just watched that movie yesterday too, so I should know that, but I do not.
I suppose some introductions are in order.
All right, we got introduced. Introduce ourselves to three of our fellow classmates.
Oh, hello.
Lenora
She's awfully regal, isn't
Everlight.
she?
Is that your owl?
I don't know who she is. Likely one of the Hufflepuffs around here. Owls choose their own company anyway. Wait, you're the new fifth year. Quite the dramatic entrance you made. Can't imagine wanting to call attention to yourself, especially since everyone will be watching to see how much you already know.
I am a bit concerned. I have a lot of catching up to do.
Indeed. 4 years of schoolwork is a bit... being that far behind, I'd feel so... inadequate. Of course, presumably, as a hard-working Hufflepuff, you'll prove yourself in no time. I'm hard-working too, as you might suspect. But sometimes I think I should have been a Ravenclaw. I've rather a searing wit. At least people have always told me so. I'm Lenora, by the way. Lenora Everly. Well, mustn't keep you. You've such a lot to do.
Do you really think you should have been in Ravenclaw?
Well, my brothers were. They both work in the ministry now. I suppose you could say that wit runs in the family. My aunt was a Gryffindor, though, and I've always had plenty in common with her. Determination, valor, daring. The old sorting hat was spoiled for choice with me.
It was nice meeting you, Lenora.
Of course. Adieu.
There's a ghost over here. Oh, I just took a cupcake. My fat ass is eating everything, and I just got here.
Arthur's got you. You don't need to be frightened, little cat.
I can't quite reach.
Come on, he went that way.
Hope they can catch him. Big castle for a student to get lost in, let alone a cat. I'm sure you'll find your way, all right. I mean, it can be a bit overwhelming at first. I still get lost sometimes. Welcome to Hufflepuff, by the way. Really glad to have you in our house. I'm Arthur.
Thank you. Nice to meet you. Was that your cat?
No, one of the first years, I think. Don't have any pets of my own, unfortunately. My mother doesn't think too highly of them, especially magical ones.
I'm sorry to hear that. I think magical beasts are rather incredible.
Best thing about coming to Hogwarts. Nifflers, Glumbumbles, Bowtruckles. I thought they were only pictures in books before. Well, Dad did bring home a puff skein once. Mum was furious. Anyway, I better go make sure the first years caught that cat. Don't want them to be late on their first day.
Nice meeting you, Arthur. And good luck finding that cat.
Thank you. Try not to get lost in the castle yourself.
Look at the cactus.
Oh, Uncle, this doesn't sound like you. Something's wrong. Oh, hello there. You're the new Hufflepuff, yes? I'm Adelaide. Pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Is everything all right?
Oh, yes. I'm just a bit distracted. Letter from my uncle. So tell me, I've been hearing all sorts of rumors. Were you really nearly gobbled up by a dragon?
That one is true.
Yeah, it was.
Not the typical start to a new school.
That's dreadful. Well, I'm glad you made it here alive. Well, anyway, I imagine you have lots to do. I hope you have a wonderful first day.
Are you sure everything is all right with your uncle?
Oh, yes. He travels for work, always busy. I'm sure he just wrote it in a rush. Nothing to worry about.
Thank you, Adelaide. Be seeing you.
Of course. And good luck.
Is the new Hufflepuff out of bed yet? Professor Weasley's waiting for them outside the common room.
All right. Let's go to Professor Weasley.
Revelio.
So wait, once that closes all the way.
Good morning. Oh. I trust you're ready for your first day at Hogwarts.
I've been dreaming of this day for a long time. Can't believe I'm here.
Well, you are here. Make the most of it. You only have one first day at Hogwarts. Now, in light of your unique situation, joining us as a fifth year, you'll need to catch up with your classmates and not fall behind. Especially as you'll be expected to complete your OWLs at the end of the year.
OWLs? OWLs?
Yes, your ordinary wizarding level exams. They will determine what type of career you can have when you leave here. After much discussion with the headmaster and the Department of Magical Education at the Ministry, we've devised something extraordinary to ensure your success. Here you are.
What is it?
It is a wizard's field guide. It will help you to keep track of what you are learning so that you master all that's expected of a fifth year. You would be wise to take full advantage of this exceptionally valuable resource.
Thank you, Professor, but what do you mean it will keep track of what I'm learning?
Perhaps seeing it in action will answer any questions you may have. Walk with me and we shall put it to the test.
Revelio.
This way.
Got a chest over here around the corner.
The guide will give you opportunities to practice your magic and educate yourself about wizarding lore. I certainly would have appreciated something like the field guide when I was a student. Using the guide will also train you to be alert to your surroundings. Do keep up.
I'm so excited. I'm so excited to explore the castle.
Simply cast Revelio on it, and we'll see what the guide says.
Revelio.
House Elf Recipe Book, rumored to contain some of Helga Hufflepuff's original creations. This book holds a collection of Hogwarts students' favorite recipes over the centuries. Some dishes like pickled dirigible plums are likely an acquired taste. You've just unlocked a field guide challenge. Your progress towards completed challenges appears here. Field guide challenges are only a way to acquire experience points or XP. This year, wizarding level XP earned from challenges increases your level and power. Your field guide tracks your current challenge progress, select the challenges menu to continue. Collecting your first guide page unlocked a new challenge category, new challenges. You unlock that, your adventure will appear here. Each challenge's tier special rewards unlock at each tier you complete, from appearances to critical upgrades. Rewards must be claimed from the challenges menu. Come back often to collect rewards you have unlocked.
Clever, isn't it?
Yeah, go back to it. So collect field pages in Hogwarts. And you have collections. This was the house elf book. We have an inventory, beast, quest items, notes, resources. There's a gear page. Black leather gloves. Gold rimmed glasses. A dark flat cap. Natural beige scarf. Our robes, of course. And then we have our outfit, which is like our under outfit, I guess. Quest, welcome to Hogwarts, required level 1. So I'm assuming you got, yeah, main quest, assignments, relationships, side, hell yeah. And then you got the map. There's 35 chests in Hogwarts, 150 field guide pages just in Hogwarts, 10 statues, and one tablet. Flu flames, that's what it's called, flu. Grand staircase, it has different locations for you to ping, essentially. We cannot change, oh yeah, we can. So this is Hogsmeade's map. 55 field guide pages. We won't look too much at that until later. I can't look at the world map currently. Yeah, I can't look at the world map. Awesome.
Open for more opportunities like that, inside and outside of the castle.
Oh yeah, and one thing, by the way, that you guys can do if you're playing the game, if you go to gear, you can actually go here and hit triangle, and you can wear the hood. So, very cool. And then you can change appearance based off of other stuff you have. I have this from the website, I believe, and this is from the deluxe pack, which is actually really cool. And then you just have the traditional robe. Actually, yeah, let's put all our cool stuff on real quick. So, dark arts scarf. We got our dark arts outfit to go underneath. Perfect vest, stylish vest. Headwear. Dark arts hat, and then we have the dark arts garrison hat. Very cool. And then we got our masks. We're gonna go with gold rimmed, and then do we have any special gloves? Yeah, dark arts gloves. Very cool. I like the way the transmog system works. You don't have to go out of your way. I got stuck on something. You don't have to go out of your way to, like, change the appearance. It's all done via inventory.
Ah, good timing. Perfect opportunity to show you how to use flu flames to get around a bit quicker. Your field guide contains a map of the castle.
Because I was supposed to
open
follow
her. Open it up and find Central Hall.
Open map. Hogwarts is divided into two main areas. The left side of the map is where students and professors live and includes the house common rooms and the Great Hall. Select the Great Hall. Select. And in this view, you can see flu flames available in this region. Green flu flames represent flames you have discovered, including your own house common room. Gray flu flames reveal the location of undiscovered flu flames. The right side of the map is where you'll find academic points of interest, including the Astronomy Tower, Library, and Greenhouse. Select the Library Annex region. Professor Weasley has unlocked the Central Hall flu flames for you. Use this to rotate, and then square to fast travel. Let's see how instantaneous this should be. It is on the PS5, but I have it on the SSD, which I think runs a little slower than the PS5 internal hard drive.
Lead directly to Central Hall. You can get almost anywhere in the castle quickly from Central Hall.
Like how great that looks. So in terms of map, is there like, there's no zoom in, huh? It's just this, okay. That's fine. It's just, I would like it to be a little more zoomed in because my brain doesn't work great.
Yeah, it's but the heart of the hive. Our King's Cross Station, so to speak.
This looks different, right, than the movie.
That should be all for now. You'll be expected to attend both Charms and Defense Against the Dark Arts classes today. And I'd like to be sure you get to Hogsmeade as soon as possible to replace the supplies you lost on the way here.
What will I learn in Charms class?
Exactly what you might expect. Spells, charms, jinxes, all terribly useful. I think you will enjoy Professor Ronan. He's a clever and entertaining wizard, and a talented teacher.
Can you tell me more about the Defense Against the Dark Arts class?
Defense Against the Dark Arts, as the name implies, focuses on how to defend oneself against the evils that lurk beyond these walls. A mastery of Defense Against the Dark Arts is required for those who aspire to become aurors. Fortunately, we are lucky to have the ever-gifted Professor Hecate in charge of our students' education in that regard.
I hope he's a cool professor. Every single Defense Against the Dark Arts teacher is dope.
Hogsmeade is the only all-wizarding village in Britain and is home to an array of shops and pubs. You should be able to find all of the school supplies you require in Hogsmeade. You will also, I imagine, enjoy many a butterbeer there with friends in due course.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
A lot to absorb on your first day, and you have much to learn.
People are saying that this game is like perfect to set up like a trilogy to finish out the years.
You'll be up to speed in no time. Judging by your adept use of Revelio earlier, I'd say Professor Fig succeeded in at least showing you the basics.
He did, Professor.
He's been terribly vague as to the events preceding your arrival, specifically about what happened after that awful dragon attack. My suspicion is that there's more to the story than a search for belongings and an extended trip up to the castle.
I'm sorry, Professor, but I'm afraid that's all there is to it.
Almost precisely what Professor Fig said. Speak of the devil, Professor Fig. Your ears must have been burning.
Oh?
Yes. You seem to have provided our new fifth year with a solid foundation in the basics of spellcasting.
Ah, I'm afraid I can't take all the credit there, Professor. They've a rare aptitude for magic, it seems.
Well, I'm just glad you both arrived in one piece. Perfectly good boats and carriages to Hogwarts, and you chose to fly in the path of a dragon.
I wouldn't say I chose the dragon's path, Professor. Rather unfortunately, it would seem that it chose us.
Very well. Enough chit-chat. I need to get to class myself. Might I rely on you, Professor Fig, to explain the details of the field guide's map?
Of course.
Thank you. Good luck today. And remember to use your field guide. It will be invaluable to you. And invaluable to me, as I'll be using it to keep up to date on your progress.
Yes, Professor.
Come and find me in my classroom after you've attended both classes today, and I'll explain more about those assignments I mentioned. And we'll see if we can't get you to Hogsmeade for those supplies.
Yes, ma'am.
It's good to see you, Professor.
And you. I was hoping our paths would cross today before you immersed yourself in studies. Did I hear you masterfully evade Professor Weasley's interrogation regarding our late arrival?
I did my best, but I'm fairly certain she suspects that we're not being entirely forthcoming.
Yes, well, Professor Weasley is a brilliant and astute witch. It was right to keep the details to yourself for now. We don't know where this path we've embarked upon will lead. It may require a bit more flexibility with your time than she would approve of. And she may feel obliged to share details with the headmaster that would be better left between us.
Understood, Professor.
Good. Now, as capable as you are, I believe the ability you possess obliges you to be well-trained. Happily, you have the benefit of an exceptionally skilled team of witches and wizards to guide you. Speaking of guides, and so that I may avoid another not-so-subtle reproof from Professor Weasley, why don't I show you the clever enchantment we included in the field guide's map? Unfold it and have a look.
Okay. This represents main quest. Completing main quest will further the story, unlock new features, and grant XP. Some quests are locked by a spell or a level requirement. In these cases, you will need to be required the required level and or have the required spell to activate the quest. New spells can be earned by completing professor's assignments or as quest rewards. Defense against the dark arts and charms class. We will be heading to charms class first.
The map is enchanted to help you find your way.
This will be incredibly helpful. Thank you.
Now, sounds like you've quite a day ahead, what with classes and a trip to Hogsmeade for supplies, including your own wand. You'll enjoy Mr. Ollivander. He's an exceptional craftsman and a good friend. I shall reach out when I have more information about our mysterious locket. For now, focus on your classes and pay attention. More than your owls may hinge on the magic you are able to master within these walls.
Yes, sir. Let's head to Charms class.
Revelio.
Oh, what is that? Come here, motherfucker. Oh, I need to get the spell for that, huh? There's a chest behind there. Okay. We have to get them all activated. We have to find all of them. I don't know. That's a whole puzzle.
Revelio.
Alright, let's do our first two classes so we can get our first couple of spells that'll help us out.
What are you up to now?
Oh, Flu Flame. That's nice. And this is Charms class. Oh, no, it's not. This is outside.
Revelio.
Sounds like there might be something above me up there. Dude. This soundtrack actually is really good. Dude. That's crazy. All right, Charms Club.
Revelio.
There's gonna be, I don't even know why I'm doing Revelio, because there's gonna be so much I'm gonna explore. I'm gonna do a lot of exploration off camera probably, and like side quests and stuff, but I'm gonna like save a good amount for on camera. But I'm definitely gonna like mess around with stuff on my own time. Is that? It's moving. Huh. It's not scary at all. Alright, we're almost to Charms class. I would explore the castle, but we need a couple of those. We need a couple spells so that we can actually get certain things. Because I know the field guide you need, What is it? How do you say it? Accio? Accio? I think it's Accio, right? I know you need Accio to be able to get a majority of the field guides. What the fuck do I do to you?
Revelio.
I don't know. I thought it would be just like an easy little... an easy little chest to get right there, but I guess not. I don't know what I gotta do to the eye.
Professor Ronan tends to go on a bit. We sometimes have to remind
him. There's a chest up here. Yeah. And another Flu Flame Charms class. The same thing here.
In the Goblin Rebellion of 1752.
So.
The Minister for Magic was Albert Boot.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, what fun! I won't say my goodbyes. I shall cheer for the boy who says
I don't know.
I'm not telling lies, Peeves. It was Albert Boot.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, hold on.
Ooh,
so that has two.
Was the Minister a Boot or the Minister a Flack?
Okay.
Stop it, Peeves. You'll get us in trouble.
In trouble, I wonder... you'll be, but you can't give Peeves a smack. She says it's a boot, and he says it's a flag.
No.
Enough. You'll get us all detention.
Let me try that, and then...
And you're both wrong anyway. It was Hephaestus Gore.
It wasn't boots, and it wasn't black, but you're all in trouble with
what?
Professor Black.
I don't know. I'm gonna have to, like, Google that or something. Like, Google just... what they're like general things I have to do to get that.
Off on another adventure,
open.
Are we?
Because I have no idea how to do those.
The last time I was at Dog.
Or maybe it's something I have to do later. Everything. I'm not sure. I don't want to Google it. I'll figure it out myself. There has to be some puzzle to it.
Here. Behind you. There is an open seat here.
Thank you.
Hello, I am Nettie. So you are the new student. Have you met Professor Ronan yet?
Shall we begin? Welcome to year 5 of Charms. Now, this will be a crucial year in your education on the art of charm work, but I am confident that we will take hold with the passion and rigor requisite of such a challenge. Right? Now, everyone, please open your textbooks to page 517. But before we begin, can anyone here tell me the difference between the incantations of the color change
okay.
and growth charms? Anyone? Anyone? Hmm? I am afraid it is too late to study now. Hmm. My, the summer months must have really taken a toll on you all. By the looks of it, you all spent your holidays practicing Obliviate on one another. Do you even remember how to perform a basic summoning charm? Hmm? Hmm. Well, it seems that we are in dire need of review. Everyone get into pairs and take positions on opposite sides of the classroom. Now let's put those textbooks to use as the blunt objects you so believe they are, and take turns summoning them out of one another's hands. Only one book will be needed per partnership, Miss Dale. Thank you. Get into place now.
It's so weird, like, that's such a weird mechanic to have.
Accio.
Accio, yes, I said it correctly.
That
we need Accio.
You are a swift learner. I see a lot of potential, but remember, potential is nothing without practice. Keep at it. You might just rival Miss Onai here. Very good, everyone. That's enough of that. Well, as you all seem to have the basics down, and it is an exceptionally lovely day, I was thinking that we might have ourselves a little excursion outside for a spot of fresh air. After me!
This game... I don't know, it's given me a feeling that I haven't felt towards the game in a while. At least new games. I can play Kingdom Hearts and get this same feeling where like I just want to keep playing and explore. I get like that with Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2.
What better than a bit of sport to put our prowess with the summoning charm to the test, right? So why don't we have our newest student start us off?
Okay.
Very simply, cast Accio on one of
Accio
the spheres.
Pulls the target closer to the castle. Hold R2 and press the sign button to cast Accio and pull the target closer. Press button again to seize casting spell.
Gobstones. Accio, but instead of throwing the marbles out, very good. Splendid! Very good. Points to Hufflepuff. But there's certainly no sport in playing without some friendly competition. Miss Onai, would you care to give our new student a bit of a challenge? Come on up. You'll be the blues, just as before, and Miss Onai, you are playing red. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
That is how it's done.
Watch this. I'm gonna get 50. Oh, I held it too long.
Don't lose your composure.
Damn it. Damn. She's better than I am. Ah, I tried to get it to 50. Take it over. It's rigged. All right, watch this. No, it held it too long. No, I didn't. Yes, I did. No, I didn't. Ha, let's go.
Brilliant.
You're goddamn right I am. She won. But it's fine. Next time I'll win.
Let us make this a bit more interesting, shall we?
Oh.
I think we are well past interesting at this point.
I'll say.
Enough chatter. Focus now. You will need it. This round settles it all.
I hope she sucks. No, she doesn't. She still somehow just gets it. Okay. Suck my balls.
Very good.
Dude, there's no way she's this good. There's no way. It's so rigged. Let's go. That's 50.
Nicely done.
Hell yeah. So I'm at 100. I don't know how I'm going to do this one. I might have to just go for the 30. Which...
Yes!
I would win if I got the 30. I just need the 30. I don't want to risk it.
Splendid!
I won. That's a cool little mini game. I like that.
Very good, both of you. Well done.
That's a super cool mini game, actually. I could see myself like it, mastering that and enjoying it.
Class is dismissed.
I mean, it's fairly simple to remaster once you get the timing down of when you're supposed to let go.
Good
but
game,
it's
like that.
Still just cool.
I must admit, I think I underestimated you.
I think you underestimated me too.
To become proficient with Accio, Took weeks for me to get anything right when I transferred here. It gets easier, I promise.
I'll be nice.
That's good to hear. It's a lot to take in all at once.
To put it lightly, I remember how I felt when I first arrived. I transferred here from Wagadu just before my fourth year.
Wagadu.
My mother received an offer to teach divination here. Before I knew it, we had left Uganda and were
happy she said
around
Uganda?
The world at a new school in a new
country.
No,
she didn't. She decided to have something else. Okay,
is Wagadu much bigger than Hogwarts?
Wagadu School of Magic is the largest wizarding school in the world. So yes, bigger than Hogwarts.
Which that's crazy because Hogwarts is massive.
It never seemed intimidating or overwhelming to me. It always felt like home.
I hope this game gets a solid post-launch
like
plan.
Hogwarts.
Its address
I hope it gets DLCs and...
It is not so much a castle as a beautiful
updates.
Edifice carved out of the mountainside.
Other than bug fixes.
I remember the first time I saw it, the mist was so thick I could hardly make out anything at all. And then it just materialized before me, this enormous school that seemed to be floating in midair.
This may seem an odd question, but is magic the same there as it is here?
Mostly, yes. But I did have to learn how to use a wand when I arrived here. Hardly anyone at Wagadu uses one.
You can cast spells without a wand.
Oh, yes. I find wandless magic to be much more instinctive. Not to mention quite convenient if one is without their wand. I must admit, however, that I am growing quite fond of using a wand. It seems very dramatic.
It's nice to learn about another wizarding school.
Thank you for asking. I do miss Wagadu, but I am glad to be here at Hogwarts. Ah, I think Professor Ronan wants to talk to you. Better not keep him waiting. Until next time.
Nice to meet you.
Revelius.
You can use Accio on humans, if you're so inclined.
Well,
oh, I know I'm gonna use
after my brother learned the summoning charm, it was constant Accio this, Accio that, cutlery flying everywhere. Quite unsafe, really.
What's up there? His office?
You wanted to speak with me, Professor?
I did. I trust your first charms lesson lived up to expectation?
Well, an outdoor competition wasn't exactly the lesson I was expecting, sir.
What charm is there in the expected? You did well, managing to best as gifted a student as Miss Onai.
Thank you, Professor. I enjoyed the match.
Miss Onai is always a fierce competitor, though I sense that she is a bit distracted of late. Now, Professor Weasley has asked that your professors give you instruction outside of the ordinary curriculum. Expect to hear from me soon regarding a special assignment that I am preparing for you.
Cool. So that's side quest, but also kind of not side quest from what I know. This is his office, I believe. It's a level 1 lock.
Revelio.
There is a chest up there, though. Okay. Let's go to our side quests are now available. Available side quests can be found inside regions of Hogwarts marked as discovered by exploring the world. The quests reward XP but do not advance the main story. So there's one here in the library annex. Like a moth to a flame. We get a new appearance from that. Looks to be... I don't know. Okay, we'll do that after we go to Dark Arts class. It said that we completed a challenge. Complete forming quest. Okay, so we got legendary gloves. If we go here, we can take a look at them. Oh, those are actually kind of cool. Look at the finger pattern. Like, kind of looks like scales. I like that. Let's wear it. And then, so we've got that. Collections, appearances. That's actually a smaller number than I expected. Only 91 appearances. And a huge amount of them are additional content. A lot of it is from quests and challenges. That is actually less than I thought. In turn, there's only 13 beasts in the game. That's fine. That's fine, because this game is still massive. And from what I know, there's actually a significant amount just in general of everything. Did I track this? No. There's a significant amount to do, and I just hope that they don't throw this game away. I hope that they give it post-launch content.
Hello.
And such.
You wanted to speak to me?
Samantha Dale. I've been eager to meet you. You're the student everyone's been whispering about. Hope your first day is going well. You certainly seem to hold your own in charms.
I've been fortunate. Beginner's luck.
My brother William would tell you not to be so humble and to trust your abilities. Then again, he tends to be overconfident in his. Well, better see to my charms homework. I'm afraid I can't count on beginner's luck to impress Professor Ronan.
Alright, let's go to Dark Arts class. I don't know if it was best to do this first, but I did it anyway.
Revelio.
I think that's part of the side quest for the lady in the library. The girl we met in the common room. Augury skeleton? This is a skeleton of Irish Phoenix or Augury, an intensely shy bird who can forecast the coming of rain and whose mournful cry was once believed to foretell death. Oh, that's the thing that's in, I completed the challenge. That's the thing that's in, Fantastic Beasts, I think the second one, I want to say. We got new glasses. See what those look like. Is it these ones? Hogwarts. Oh, those are cool. I'm not gonna wear them. That's cool. Alright, let's go to Dark Arts class.
Revelio.
Can I do anything with this? No. I just don't want to miss too many field guides, because there's a lot of them, and I would like to not have to backtrack too much. I mean, if I have to, it's not an issue, but I would like to... Look at these reflections. Or, I mean, shadows.
How nice to see you, my
that
young
looks
friend.
Great. This is why I chose fidelity mode, too, by the way, because this is not a thing in performance mode, from what I know. This type of lighting, and I wanted the best lighting I could possibly have, because it's just a pretty looking game.
Is that all you've got?
Levioso! Professor Hecate!
Perhaps you'd be good enough to blast each other to pieces on your own time. I get new students every year, but I only have one Hebridean black skull. It was a token from the Great Poacher Raid of 1878. No doubt you've heard of it. Now, you may be asking yourself how an old woman like me single-handedly took out the largest poacher ring in Eastern Wales and lived to boast about it. Knowledge. To the wise, age matters very little. Today, we will review a spell that has saved me from death at the hands of dark wizards more times than I care to remember. Levioso.
Levioso? A levitation charm?
Levioso! A surprised opponent is a weak opponent. Care to defend yourself, Master Pruitt? No? One thing I've learned as an unspeakable is the value of simplicity, especially in the heat of battle. Now, let's practice what we've just learned, starting with something small.
All right, Levioso. Oh, fuck. I forgot to hit X when I went around the corner. Levioso. Not Levioso.
Levioso.
Isn't it Levioso? Or is it Levioso? Levioso, not
now,
Levioso.
Let's try something a little larger.
I don't know. Levioso.
Let us begin with the basic cast.
Oh, basic cast.
See how the dummy deflected your cast? This time, cast Levioso first, then the basic cast. Remember, a surprise. Well done.
Cool.
Very good. But the best way to practice is by dueling. We'll start with you two. Duelist, take your marks.
Time for a proper Hogwarts welcome.
Now, I want a fair duel, using only Levioso, basic cast, and Protego. You may begin.
You hear that, you goddamn Slytherin?
I know. Nothing lucky about it.
This could be
Protego. Let's just say it.
Oh, I hit the wrong button.
You're good. Now,
stupendous. I do. You're lively too.
Levioso.
Try to anticipate your opponent's next move.
Not bad for a beginner. You give as good as you get.
At least he dueled fairly.
I put you on the spot, and you rose to the challenge. Points to Hufflepuff.
Thank
Hell
you,
yeah.
Professor.
Is the house cup Glad even in the game? I don't think it is.
If what I've seen today is any indication, we can expect great things from you. I demand excellence from my students. They are capable of achieving it, and they must achieve it. A classroom duel is one thing, but battling dark wizards, or as ever more likely, goblins, is a different kettle of Grindelows entirely.
Understood, Professor.
So, I'd advise you to keep practicing whenever you can. Perhaps Mr. Sallow will have some ideas for you. Again, well done today. I shall reach out soon with additional assignments. All Rebellion. Right. That's enough spectacle for one day. Class is dismissed.
Hebridean Black Skeleton. This large dragon skeleton that hangs in the defense against the Dark Arts classroom is allegedly a trophy taken by Professor Hecate. After she single-handedly defeated one of the largest poaching wings in Eastern Wales during the Great Poacher Raid of 1878.
Revelio. If you know the right spells, it's dark wizards that'll fear you, not the other way around.
Oh. Wow.
Nice work.
I enjoyed that.
Well, that duel was quite something. Everyone will be talking about it.
It was certainly good practice.
Practice? It felt more like I was dueling an expert. Sebastian Sallow, by the way. Didn't expect a new student to be so deft with a wand. Then again, perhaps this wasn't your first duel.
Have I fought when... No.
I've had enough. Consider yourself lucky I held back.
That's not what I meant to say.
You owe me an honest duel when you aren't. You know,
You might be a perfect fit for a certain exclusive, unsanctioned dueling organization.
Exclusive and unsanctioned. Count me in.
Excellent. Knew I was right about you. If you want to get the most out of your time at Hogwarts, you're going to need to break the rules now and then. Whether it's joining a secret dueling club, or sneaking into the restricted section of the library, you just have to be clever enough not to get caught.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll keep that in mind.
Good. Pleasure chatting with you. I'm sure I'll see you soon. Perhaps somewhere unsanctioned? We'll see if your performance today was sheer luck or actual skill. Look for Luke and Brattleby near the clock tower entrance, if you're interested.
Okay. That could be that could be fun to do right now, actually. So, if I remember, it's gone. Did I wait too long? Oh, wait. This quest is still technically going.
Revelio.
Now if I... Okay. Let's go... We're gonna go do the side quest that's down... in the library. There's actually two in there right now. So we're gonna do both of those, and then we'll go over here and we'll start the dueling crossed wands round one. And then we'll do that. But let's go down here. Let's do these ones first. This one first. Collections. Sorry if I don't get rid of the exclamation marks, it's gonna annoy me. Alright, we're good. Alright, let's head to the library. So, I did Google something. It wasn't the answers to the,
Revelio.
I didn't... Was that cutting itself? Yes, it was. Very cool. I didn't Google the answers to those doors with the beast symbols, but I did Google how you're supposed to solve them, and in the library there's actually a... I don't know how to activate this. In the library there's a sheet that you get, and it kind of guides you on what you need to know to unlock those doors. Is there a chest in here somewhere? No, I think that's inside, huh?
Revelio.
Yeah, that's inside. Okay. Let's go in the library. Okay, see, so yeah, it's another one of those doors. Hell yeah. Oh, well, oh, okay, never mind. We're where we were earlier. So, in the library, somewhere. Is this the library? This is a library annex. I think this is where it's supposed to be. So somewhere in here...
There's something in there.
Revelio.
Hold on, before we do that quest, somewhere in here is supposed to be...
I really have made a mess of things.
A chest or something that has the paper in it that we need for the door. Oh, right up there. Wait, is that it? How do I get up there? This goes down. Do both of these go down? Yes. I need to get in that room somehow.
Revelio.
I have no idea how to get up there.
Hello, Lenora. What are you looking at?
A
Everyone thinks I'm utterly balmy. Samantha thinks I'm potty. But it's this painting. I never noticed it before. If I know Hogwarts, and I do, an empty frame doesn't appear for no reason. There's something more to this.
Have you gained any insights about the painting since you've been studying it?
I did discover that casting Lumos has an effect of some kind. But I'm not sure what to do next.
Are there any other empty paintings like this around the school?
Yes, a few. This entire place is somewhat of a riddle, to be honest. If I can work out the riddle of this one, I'll know what to do with all of them. As good a place as any to begin.
If I have the time, I may look. Could be intriguing.
I've been racking my brains long enough. I hope you'll have better luck than I have.
Alright, so I'm actually going to end the video here because I did not realize that I only have 4 more minutes until the recording stops. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Hogwarts Legacy. If you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Comment down below what you guys want to see on the channel in the future. And next episode, we'll probably focus on side quests for the first half or so. Yes, I'll see you guys very soon in the next one. Stay safe out there, and peace out.